Hello world, it's Uper Al. We are here in the beautiful town of South Milwaukee, Wisconsin. South Milwaukee is an environ slash suburb about 10 miles due south of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, on the shores of Lake Michigan. It is primarily an industrial town, formed in about 1891, became a city in 1892. To the B. Cyrus, Cyrus Mining Corporation, which is directly to the left of me here. See a little bit of it in a minute. Huge mining corporation. It's since been bought by Caterpillar. It's been pretty much the life force of this entire community down here. And this has been primarily ever since the 1800s, a total industrial town. From Milwaukee, serving Milwaukee and all the businesses here. And it still remains that to this day. Town's about 20,000 people. It's about 91% white, 2% African American, 1% Asian, and then the rest is Latino, Native American races that make up the rest of the population. I think the Latino population is probably more than 2% here, though. It's grown quite a bit in this town since the last census. Nonetheless, pleasant little town, just south of Cudahy. I did a video in Cudahy once. This is directly south of Cudahy, Wisconsin, as you're heading towards Chicago. As I said, it's on the lake. Some decent parks on the lake, Grant Park. It's a very nice place to go swimming, hang out. They got a boat launch there. And here's part of B. Cyrus Corporation over here. Just gonna take a nice little walk to the downtown. They fixed up their train station. It no longer services public transportation, but I do believe there's a bar or something in there. Things for events that you can see, hang out and do things. Pleasant day today. It's about 72 degrees. September 25th. Fall's in the air. Decided to come down here for work. Take a nice little log from here. South Milwaukee's home to Reggie the Crusher, famous wrestler from the 70s, early 80s. Just to see that guy running around here as a kid with a quarter barrel tied to his back, running through the park, getting in shape. A nice town. I knew a few people that lived in South Milwaukee. Been down here, pretty familiar with the area down here. Pretty quiet. Don't got a lot of crime down here. You are close to the city, just like any other suburb around Milwaukee. I mean, there are some gangs and stuff like that. Not gangs, but gang members from the city that live down here. So you could have that element, but it's not a bad town to live in. Your crime's pretty low, but they do have problems. You know, there is robberies and theft and fights and things that happen in big cities, but it's not a bad place. It's a safe place to raise your kids. I would raise my kids here. I would totally, you know, if I had a choice to live down here, if I would live here, I would live here. It's not a bad place. But crime does happen. Just be aware of that. I don't quite know how their school system here is. It's not MPS, so it's not Milwaukee Public Schools, so you probably get a little bit of a better education out of it. There's always private school. As far as housing here, you can find some fixer-uppers in the mid-100,000s and up. You want something on the lake, you're going to pay pretty penny. Not as expensive as the North Shore of Lake Michigan, but nonetheless, those houses are in the high 100,000s. Maybe even a million for some of them. Really don't know. It's out of my price range, I'll tell you that. Yeah, you see their downtown. Not a lot of people out today, but it is a vibrant little downtown. A lot of mom and pop stores, restaurants, and bars. You can see they're taking care of things around here. Keeping stuff maintenance, keeping up with maintenance. Painting the walls. Very clean. You don't have homeless bums and drug addicts or nothing like that running around here. So even for being in a big city, this is very affordable, very pleasant place to live. My uncle worked at the library down here for years. South Milwaukee Library. Which is right over there by the yellow sign. It's the other crossroad here that goes through the downtown. Packard Avenue. I'm doing a lot of fixing up around here. A lot of people working on stuff here. Over there painting a mural over there. It's a work day, so there's not a lot of people out. They get it in on the weekends. They don't have a very big downtown. Nonetheless, there's some nice buildings, older architecture. And it just kind of fiddle-faddles out into residential neighborhoods as you go toward Lake Michigan. Lake Michigan's right in front of me, probably about 7-8 blocks, maybe a little further than that. Close to the airport here. I do have the bus system that runs through here to get you back into Milwaukee. And the neighborhood here is changing, becoming a lot more Latino. Nonetheless, this is a pretty good mixture of diversity of people through here. It's a pretty open community. People don't, you know, they don't judge anybody here. You just mind your business, stay out of trouble. Everything's all good in this neighborhood, so you don't really have to worry about that kind of stuff. It's pretty open here, pretty welcoming. Got some pretty good food options down here. I don't frequent South Milwaukee a lot as far as eating and hanging out, but I have been down here throughout my life, growing up in Milwaukee, to events and a few restaurants and stuff down here. I said I had a few friends that lived here. But nonetheless, I thought it was a nice part of the Milwaukee area I'd like to show you. That's just about it for their downtown here. Azteca is good. I've eaten there. That place is pretty good Mexican food. Got a little clinic here at the end of downtown. Another bar. And that's about it for them. South Milwaukee, Wisconsin. So let me know what you think. Like, subscribe, thumbs up. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think about South Milwaukee. Tell me something I don't know or left out. With that, guys, I hope you all have a beautiful day out there, world. It's Youper Al. I'm taking you places.